All winter, they scream and shout over the airwaves, telling us what's happening to our favourite team. You either love them or hate them, but you can't ignore them. They're the football callers, and it's probably understating it to say they are a breed of their own.
Watch it again.
And if I drop dead now from a heart attack.
He's absolutely the best player in year to year, but that's all, folks.
Did you get a block of units out of that 78 grand final?
You're a guest, shut up.
He used to be a man with a stick in his hand.
It's a fight on in mid-square.
If you thought that the action on the field was fast and furious, you should see behind the scenes. Tonight you get the opportunity to go behind the closed doors of the commentator's booth.
Now Ricky Walford sends one up to Michael Beattie. Beattie tries to make the bus, gives it across now to Walford. Walford says go, and he puts...
Greg Hartley, former referee, and Peter Peters, former player. Hartley the motor mouth, and Peters the big mouth. Together they can talk up a storm.
You used to come up with...
Yeah, I know all about that.
Except when you refereed Manly, it would go Manly's way.
That penalty sucks, Peter, dead set.
They call them the Laurel and Hardy of rugby league commentators. And while the players might be giving it to one another on the field, these blokes are always at each other's throats.
From the halfway mark. What's that ball patch there?
That ball patch, I'm in big trouble. What about this tyre around here? Don't worry about the ball patch.
I can do something about the tyre.
Yeah, well, I've been waiting 10 bloody years for you to do it and nothing's happened. As a matter of fact, you've got retreads.
For the purists who like a straight call with no frills, there's always a relatively formal ABC. But for sheer entertainment, Hartley and Peters claim to be simply the best. The animated antics of these two fill the listener with side-splitting laughter. All good harmless fun. Hartley and Peters have been a team for 10 years, and they're the first to admit their bark is bigger than their bite. But if Hartley ever does get out of hand, Peters knows exactly how to cool him down.
I poured water over him one day because he really annoyed me. I don't respect his knowledge of the game as much as I should, I suppose. But then again, I'm not all that au fait on referees.
Has that fun ever gotten out of hand where you've almost come to blows?
Yeah, I've given him a whack over the ear a couple of times and he's walked out of the box and left me calling it on my own. And he's come back though.
And then there's the mouth from the south.
Brown's there and I'm trying to pick up all the bloody names, but I can't even try and get them as they go down towards the full forward line. Over towards
in a city where football is a religion, Melbourne's Rex Hunt is a high priest of Australian rules commentating.
And a beautiful mark has been taken over there by young Scholl of North Melbourne. And the Monsignor would be proud of umpire Sheehan as he crossed himself here at the Sabbath.
Whether it's the Hawks, Magpies or Swans, if he ruffles a few feathers, then so be it.
Oh, well, I cope very well with it because I'm Rex Hunt and they're not, and that's the standing joke. The fact of the matter is, if they don't like Rex Hunt, they can switch that dial to the left to another station, and that is their prerogative. And I think the great thing about human relationships is choice. It's like governments, it's like schools, you have a choice, and I think that the ratings show that quite a few people like my style, and those that don't listen anyhow.
There's plenty of people listening to Sydney's Ray Hadley. A former auctioneer, the 2UE caller has a gob that gallops all the way past the winner's post as the top rating caller in rugby league. Hadley's bitter rivals Hartley and Peters are always ready to chop him down. They say Hadley is a poor imitation.
You gave me such a bad time. Tried to hurt me, but now I know.
They've all tried to copy us, but you know what they say about plagiarism or copying people. You know, I think it's terrific that they're all getting a living out of doing what they all said we'd never make a success.
No, we haven't copied them. I was screaming and yelling long before I started calling football, when I was a race broadcaster and boxing commentator and doing other things.
I think, you know, there's a lot of people calling the game that have no right to.
Peter, of course, has never been accused of suffering of delusions of adequacy. I mean, he's got huge raps on himself.
There was a time when he went on a little bit childish. I think he's grown up a bit now.
According to Hadley, it's Hartley and Peters who need to grow up. And now back in the fray is Channel 9's Ray Warren. After years with the Channel 10 network, Ray got a new lease of television life this year.
Lions will score! Try time for the Eagles!
Just because Channel 9 has a monopoly on the league television coverage doesn't mean the man they call Rabbits won't roast his radio rivals. Earlier this year, he locked horns with 2UE over the right to interview the stars of State of Origin football.
The State of Origin cost a hell of a lot of money. And part of that agreement is that they would have first go at the players at the end of the match. And it got after, I think it was State of Origin 1, it got to the point that we were struggling to get interviews because radio stations or other television stations had grabbed the personnel.
Well, I can't help it if they employ inept people who can't beat our people to the sideline. I mean, what they should do is perhaps poach John Gibbs and Greg Pritchard to TV because they get there first every time.
And you thought it was a battle on the football field, but the action on the ground at times just can't compare with the war of words in the grandstand above.
There's a battle in radio like you wouldn't believe. I mean, I can go back when I was calling radio. In the days of Frank Hyde and Cole Pearce and Tiger Black and myself, it was nothing like it is today. I mean, these guys, it's the heavyweight championship in radio these days.
I mean, there's very big money involved now. We're the number one station. We attract something like $1.4 million in revenue. Now, if we're overtaken by the other two stations, well, it'll be a cut in pay for me and a cut in revenue for the station. So it's very, very competitive.
But football is not a matter of life and death. It's more serious than that. And people look forward every week to going to the footy. And look, I think that I am the person representing the people who can't get to the game.
With big bucks and even bigger egos involved, each weekend sees these guys stepping into the ring. The gloves are off, the microphones are on, and it's gob eat gob. And around final time, the action can only get more frantic.
But Christian now for Collingwood has got the football and comes back. How can Christian be playing for North Melbourne? I'm f***ed if I know because I can't bloody say this any longer.
Gee, if you think women are bitchy, you ought to get into this caper.
Well, at least they're upfront about the way they feel.